Stinger transitions are a great way to improve your production value for your streams and videos. These stinger transitions are a transition between two scenes where a visual of some sort, an animated logo, text, or even just a shape in general, enters over top of the first scene and generally fills the frame to hide the transition to the second scene. A new OBS update enhances those transitions by letting you mask certain areas, combining it with the idea of a Luma matte transition, and can help make them even higher quality in the future. Here's an example. I'm EposVox, the stream professor, and the version 27 update for OBS Studio has just entered beta. I've been covering a few of the updates in different videos. I'll keep an updated playlist link in the video description so you can keep up with all of my content on OBS 27. This update comes with a specific change for stinger transitions, track matte support. Track mats are basically a way of indicating how a video file should be masked between two video sources to act as an overlay, typically as a transition between them. This is used in place of a normal transition point indicator, usually by saying at what point in milliseconds or which frame in the animation is the transition point. That's how you had to do it before for stinger transitions. That option is still available, but now you have this new option. The uses for transitions here actually go beyond what you might traditionally think of for stinger transitions. That is when a graphic comes in and fills the frame to hide the cut between your two scenes, and it allows you to do lots of cool transitions between the two scenes that actually still shows the scenes as they're transitioning in unique ways. Track mats work by identifying the black areas as one of the clips, say the scene that you're transitioning from, and the white areas as the other clip, the scene you're transitioning to. Then in editing software, you'd typically use a track matte effect that you would drag onto the clip and then specify which, you know, black and white, which is which, and overlay your clips and bam, you have a transition. This differs from stinger transitions, which use a graphic on an alpha channel transparent background to pull in a graphic over top of the scene. Track mats themselves don't require alpha channels. They're a non-transparent video, and the track matte process is what causes the transparency. But to use them in conjunction with stingers here in OBS Studio, it does require alpha for the stinger side of the transition. Otherwise, it doesn't know what it's masking out here. So unfortunately, my recent investigation into which media formats are best for media sources and stinger transitions in OBS Studio still applies here. Go watch that video if you missed it. To use a track mat with a stinger transition in the new OBS update, add your stinger transition that's rendered out with the track mat and check Use Track Mat. Now, you don't need to specify a frame or time to transition as it will just follow the track mat. You do have the option of using separate stinger and track mat files as individual video files, but to keep them in sync, it's best to put them in the same file. So let's look at how I built my example. So for my example transition, I took my usual stinger transition of my CRT animation coming in and filling the frame, but I tediously masked out the screen and another VHS animation so that at a certain point it glitches and becomes transparent. What can I say? I love torturing myself for these videos, and the baby was watching the Wiggles and being good anyway. Now I have a stinger transition that has a window for the second scene to show up in. While I could go on and export this out and set the usual transition point, both the inside of the CRT and the outside would transition at the same time, which is, it doesn't look as cool. So instead, we need to build our track mat. In a new composition. With these, you need a masking animation of two colors, black and white. Black indicates scene one, the scene that you're transitioning from, and white indicates scene two, the scene that you're transitioning towards. I will note here that OBS will give you the option to invert the mask color, so you can do the opposite if that's necessary for your work, but working with the defaults of black to white is usually the way to go, as I described. So since I already made and tracked my mask for the CRT, I simply made a new composition with white and black solids and copied my mask keyframes at the right point in time to the white solid. Then, once it reaches the point where the whole scene is supposed to show scene 2, not just the masked bit, I have another full screen white solid show up to fill the screen at the exact point that it normally would. Otherwise, if I just let it push in and then push back into the black, then it will cut back to scene 1 before it finishes scene 2 and doesn't work right. We're not done yet, however. Now you need to put these two compositions in the same composition, either side by side with the stinger transition on the left and the track mat on the right, or stacked with the stinger transition up top. So for a 1080p transition, this would either be 3840 by 1080 for side by side, or 1920 by 1060 for stacked vertically. Make sure the timing of these lines up, of course. Now export this out with alpha and add it to OBS. Enable track mat in the stinger transition properties, choose the layout side by side or vertical, invert the colors if you need to, and preview it to make sure everything is working smoothly. And wham, bam, you have some absolutely sick transitions. I will say that what I have done here, while pretty cool IMO, is honestly the low-hanging fruit of what can be done here. There's a ton more possibilities, and I'm stoked to see what everyone comes up with. I will be experimenting with some new VHS-style transitions with this new feature, which I will give away some of on our Discord server. Join us at discord.gg/EposVox. You know what else I'm stoked for? New creators getting into streaming or YouTube to find a career path or build an audience. For that, I recommend checking out Marquez Brownlee's latest Skillshare course on YouTube success. Skillshare is our sponsor for today's video and is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring courses for creative and curious people on topics such as graphics design, photography, freelancing, music production, and of course, video production, like the course I'm recommending. They even have classes from some familiar faces, such as the new course from MKBHD that I just recommended. It should be at the top of your list. Skillshare is for real working creatives and lifelong learners who are never content being stuck where they're at and always want to improve. That sounds like a lot of my viewers. It's curated specifically for learning, so there's no ads and there's always new premium courses being launched like MKBHD's. For less than $10 per month with an annual subscription, it's a fantastic deal. But if somehow that's not good enough for you, the first 1,000 people to sign up with my link in the description will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium. Happy learning. Unfortunately, despite what some comments had suggested on my media format investigation video, this does not eliminate the need for alpha channel and hardware acceleration for stinger transitions. Hopefully, they will one day enable chroma keying for stingers and save us a lot of headache, although causing more headaches, but today is not that day. I'm showing another way that your transitions can become more powerful in the next video on this update, so stay tuned. I'm EposVox, the Stream Professor. Hit the like button if you enjoyed, subscribe for more tech education and stream guides, and sound off in the comments with what transition ideas you come up with. See ya.